Mahi has been GoDaddy's brand ambassador for the last 12 months in the avatar of Bijness Bhai. So if you think of business, right, it's all about being a leader. It's all about knowing your competition and market so you can make the right decisions. And it's all about different platforms, different scenarios require different kind of trainings. And you're going to hear these interactions with Mahi in the next few minutes. All of us remember the 2007 World Cup, the last ball victory we had, and the last over given to Joginder Sharma. And you know, we asked Mahi what was going through his head and what was his basis of actually deciding who should bowl the last over. So here's his perspective on what made him decide to give that last over to Joginder Sharma.
People ask me, why you gave Joginder Sharma the last over? I was like, you know, 2004 I was playing against Pakistan A. So it was Pakistan A, India A and Kenya. We were playing in Kenya. Misbah ul Haq was part of that team. He was hitting the spinners like anything. And come 2007, which is 3 years later, he's batting. And the over before that, Vachupa bowled. He hit them for two sixes. So, you know, in 2004, again, he has done the same thing, which means he's a great player of spin. So now, whether I would give that over to Harbhajan Singh again. Harbhajan Singh was my premium bowler throughout the tournament. He had done really well. So you weigh in and you say, no, I'm giving a medium fast bowler. Yes, Joginder Sharma was not express at that point of time, but I was like, I'm not giving it to the spinner. The wicket was also flat, it was a good wicket. I'm like, I'll give it to a fast bowler. So when you remember the learnings from the past, it actually helps you in the future. You know, all these small things you keep in mind, it actually helps you. So to keep it simple, never think about the result, you'll have less pressure on yourself.
So most recently, everybody was very interested and intrigued by Mahi's going up and training with the army in Jammu and Kashmir. So we actually asked him a question about how different was it versus being on a cricket ground, versus being up in the mountains with really no equipment and very limited access to what you would normally get on a cricket field.
I think we can really compare because both of them are very different and the physical demands are very different. Yeah. Both of them are mentally very challenging, but the physical demand of the army is completely different, especially when you're posted in the valley, you know, because it's a valley, but mostly you're not in the valley, you're moving around and, you know, you're in the ridge line. And the best thing is when you get a chance to climb up, it's not like trekking because they carry everything, they're out. So the best thing is once you climb, you realize it is very tough. And once you reach the top, then everybody around you, they tell you, this was easy, going down this stuff. So, it was a lot of fun because when we moved, we were a very small group and you know, we had a lot of fun for the first 2-3 days and then we had different kind of engagement after that, you know, for the next 8 days. And after that, we went to Ladakh, which in its own way is very challenging, you know, because the oxygen content is very less, so they don't allow you to do anything. At time when you feel as if it's a joke because, you know, morning there'll be a doctor coming checking you up, evening, you know, there'll be another doctor coming and checking you up. But that's how difficult the terrain is. So hats off to them, they operate over there with all the great difficulties and yet they have a big smile on their face. So I feel physically both of them as they have very different demands, you know, competing in a sport is very different and, you know, being there in the army, it's entirely different. The demands are very different. And also cricket is, I don't see it as a very physical sport. We get ample rest in the middle, you know, even like if you're a fast bowler, that's the most workload I feel, you know, as a fast bowler. So you need to run in and bowl with a lot of effort, but in between you get time to rest. Which may not be the case, you know, once you are in the army, if you're moving from one place to the other place, it's not like you can just rest anywhere. You have to have a look at the surroundings, which is a safe place, which is a place where you are sitting at a dominant position. So a lot of things, you know, go into consideration because also it's a matter of life and death over there. So it's entirely different. And I think how they operate, it's a very professional environment. But a tough environment.
You know, many times in business, we see brand ambassadors and they engage with outside world on behalf of the brand. But we have doing something very different. We're actually engaging our own brand ambassador to touch and feel the lives of over 500 of our employees in India.
Some are more social, some are very product related, some are a lot of fun. But I felt this ad was, it was very nice. Maybe it was my first ad which was different from just endorsing the product. So it's like first love. Challenge tha ki hum TV pe kaise promote kare. You know, jab aap ek ad banate ho, aap kis tarike se, kis base ko touch karoge. And again, time ka restriction hota hai. 30 second, 20 second, 15 second, 12 second, matlab isme kaise ho payega. So, wo ek bahut bada challenge tha. If I am on board, you know, company agar spend kar rahi hai, I am on board, hum itni mehnat kar rahe, wo puri cheezon ko address kar raha hai. And at the same time, people are getting curious about it within that time limitation. So I felt it was nicely done. Couldn't have been more perfect.
So what are the analogies you could think about? You know, we asked Mahi, what are the analogies one can apply from the sports field, from being a captain to actual business world? And what are the similarities and perhaps what are the dissimilarities and get his perspective on that?
You are part of something for what you bring onto the table. You can't make a presentation what the boss will like. You make a presentation according to your skill set, saying this is what I think is important or is the right way to go according to me. You may or may not be right or wrong. The boss, he's sitting there, you can always say, okay, this is the reason behind it. He may or may not like it, but at least he knows if I give a job to a particular person, you know, this is what I'm getting out of him. So you are showing your real character to him. A lot of times we get some kind of a work and we actually go beyond what we are known for. It's not about impressing. The boss will get impressed depending on your work. And your work entirely depends on the talent you have and how well or how much you are confident about your own work. Never try to impress the boss. He will get impressed, which is very rare. I know the boss never gets impressed. And it always brings a smile on everybody's face. But you know, keep it simple. Be honest to yourself. Honesty is a great thing to have, which is, I feel, one of the most important characters that we are missing. You know, at least try to be honest to yourself. You know, we have developed the habit of not being honest with others, but at least be honest to yourself. Then all the shortcomings you can accept. You know, if you're honest to yourself, you can say, yes, this is a shortcoming that I have. You may not share the same thing with someone else because it may seem to you as a weakness, but you can't lie to yourself. So be honest and, you know, it will actually help you in the future to improve yourself.
Thank you very much.
You know, on behalf of GoDaddy team, thank you very much.
As always, you know, there is a brand association and there's a relationship. And I feel with GoDaddy, we feel like a relationship. So thank you for being part of our journey. A pleasure having you here.